to make these bums mad again. Uh-oh. Back to them. I lead the pack, so my back's to them. Yup, the queen's back. What's happening? Rerun, about to make these rap again. Diamond chains on my ankle. Young money in the cut like a tell tip rubber bands on my bankroll. Show my like a
big bank, tight, low bank, bank. Big bank, tight, low bank, bank. Type of money you gon' need a sight. The type of money you gon' need a buy. From the hood, this type of money make you stay away. Type of money gon' let you. Big bank, tight, low bank, bank. Big bank, tight, low bank, bank.
Okay, pocket too big, they sumo. Pulling card like Uno. Flip like Judo. You act too Kudo. You and her no chance, you go. Pocket too big, they sumo. 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 Pull card like Uno. Flip like Judo. You act too Kudo. You and her no chance, you go. Pocket too big, they sumo. 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 Tell me who the hottest. If it ain't me, you Curry get the flame calling Brent Zuko. Swimming through the money like a flounder. Hold up. I just want the knowledge and the power. Hold up. Why the looking at me sour? Eat a like chowder. Rada, 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 rada. Never gave a about a dollar. More money, me, more problems. Pray for me to fall like autumn. Cause I got it on my own with no help. In myself, main up. They need a new hope. Deal of a new. Giving up like Shaq at the free throw. Anybody wanna be ET? Man, y'all can't see me. Out of my league, you pee.
And coach, we come at you from the shores of Lake Erie. EA Sports has the coverage of the NFL from First Energy Stadium here in Cleveland, Ohio. Nothing like the fanfare of introductions to an NFL game, and that was in evidence a moment ago. Fireworks, pyrotechnics, you name it, this crowd is ready as their guys get set to match up between the Pittsburgh Steelers and the Cleveland Browns. To return it now, here's King. He's got a convoy, and he might be gone. 20, 10, and touchdown, Cleveland, as his guys are in for six, and the Browns have taken the early lead.
Brandon, my man, just one sentence for that one. Clinic.
And that's what they've done. They lead the league in points per game this season, but it's been quick strike ability, as we saw on that drive.
I think they're actually intimidating defenses because they're back on their heels right away, wondering where it's going to come from, how they're going to hit them. This group is well-organized, well-coached, and extremely confident in what they do.
Lutz with the extra point, and it's now a 7-0 game. So now the other return teams out there as they'll try to duplicate what they just saw. And they will not get a chance to return this one as it's through the end zone for a touchback. James Conner, and he'll get this one up to the 26. Larry Ogunjobi there to make the tackle.
They tried a quick hitter inside, but that one was swallowed up because what they're hoping, those big defensive linemen will take the bait and move laterally and open up a crease that they can run through. Didn't happen on that play.
The last play got just a yard. Here's second and 9 from the 26. On second down, Roethlisberger. He'll find Juju Smith-Schuster. And they work this well upfield across the 45. 23 yards on the play. just the first quarter, but tackling going to be so important going forward. They've got to limit plays like that.
And that's something when you see it happen early in the game and they don't get him on the ground, you can always tell that they were concerned about it going in. Because I can just tell you from my days, I remember being in college and worrying all offseason about our season open opponent, and they had a receiver that could shake and bake with the best of them. I tackled him on the first pass of the game, and the relief was incredible. Ended up having a pretty decent ball game. But if I had missed him, it would have been a
story.
Long night.
On second down, here's Roethlisberger. Throwing middle, but it's incomplete. Juju Smith-Schuster, the intended receiver that time. And it'll bring up third down.
I don't think either one of us is surprised about who they just targeted on that one. I mean, they're going to try and get to him as much as possible. Off to a nice start, but unable to haul that one in.
Yeah, already looked his way a couple of times on this opening drive. Can't connect there. On third down, Roethlisberger. Yeah, it's a short one here, complete to the tight end. And he'll be taken down at the 44-yard line. They get only four that time as that leads us to a fourth down. Out is Rigoberto Sanchez on fourth down to punt this thing. They punted three times in the loss last week as he sends this one away. And this will hit just beyond the goal line as it's into the end zone for a touchback. Mayfield going to lead the Browns up now, first and 10 at the 20.
Four down. All right, now, lucky 56.
First down, Mayfield. And the Steeler pressure too much here. He's going down. T.J. Watt in there to make the sack. He buries him for a loss of 10. So now 20 yards to go on second down after the sack. Work to be done.
Back at it on Philly. Here we go.
Mayfield looks to throw. Oh, the ball comes out on the hit, but they'll say it's incomplete.
They're bringing a lot of pressure here already in the first quarter. Already sacked him once. Now they get in there and knock another one away. You think maybe that tougher will be in guard? Defense is a lot bolder.
Yes, indeed. That time, lucky that the arm was going forward. Incomplete pass.
All right, now, lucky 56. Lucky 56.
Third and long for Mayfield. Got his man complete over the middle. That's King. He got 29 yards that time. And defensively, they were in zone coverage there. Do you have to be a little careful? You're losing playing against a good quarterback like he is, to not play too much zone?
Yeah, you have to be careful about how much time you're giving up. I think it's a good point you just brought up. So maybe if you still want to play zone, go to a zone blitz scheme, and you can drop anyone out of your defensive front, defensive end, defensive tackle. It doesn't matter. You just exchange someone to bring more pressure towards the quarterback and still try and cover downfield.
Second down, Mayfield. Throwing right, and that's complete. A really good pickup of 28 yards. Well, they're piecing together a nice drive to start this one. Seems pretty scripted and pretty successful so far.
And I think they did it without our help. Because you remember when we sat in the production meeting with them to talk about this, and hey, you know, how are you guys going to come out of the gate? I know I offered my help with a few plays, and they didn't seem to want it.
I didn't offer mine.
You know, you were the smart one. Whatever they're doing, though, it's working really well.
Here's Mayfield. Buying time to this one. And the ball is knocked out, and it looks like Steeler football. It is.
When I see a play like that, I come back to risk reward. I don't know about you, but is it worth it at that point, whatever you're going to pick up, to either take the hit, and in this case, lose the football.
So should have gone down. I mean, hindsight's always 20-20, but that's the safe play.
You're exactly right. Hindsight's really never wrong, is it? Because you can analyze it. But I think ultimately you got to look at it as a first option taking care of the ball, getting what you can, and that's it. Don't worry about it anymore.
And it's a short one here, complete to his tight end. And he'll go down just shy of the 25 at the 24-yard line. Give him a couple on the catch. It's second and 8. So second and 8 here after the pass play for 2 yards on first down. Roethlisberger will hand to Connor. And he is met in his tracks behind the line of scrimmage. It'll be a loss of a full 3 yards there, and it also brings up third down. And on third down, a nickel formation here defensively. Out of the gun, it's Roethlisberger. And incomplete. The contact made the ball roam free and brings up fourth down.
It's never a bad idea to try and get it to Antonio Brown, but there must be a little bit of the Madden curse going on for our cover athlete here. Hasn't been able to get that elite separation that we're used to seeing from him.
And the punt team on now as this one sent away. It's fielded at the 45. 31 yards on the punt there. And the Browns have a short field in front of them now as they take over first and 10. And now the Browns coming out on the field. And last drive, obviously not what you're looking for. You've got the lead. You've got to protect the football.
So in other words, someone got lucky because they've been moving the ball really well and wearing them down. In this case, though, giving up the football doesn't make them very happy. They can't wait to get back out there and atone for it.
Yeah, try to atone for it here on this drive. Now, the first play of the drive there is incomplete.
Didn't have a receiver open downfield, and as it turned out, couldn't even find his outlet, man, because of the coverage. It was way too tight. Unable to find anyone open.
An incomplete pass on first down. That leads to a second and 10.
Now let's go! Blue Liney! Blue Liney!
Working out of the gun, Mayfield. He's going to air one out. So the long attempt falls innocently to the ground, and it brings up third.
Fans do love the long ball, don't they? And he already found his guy once. Tried to give him another chance there, didn't he?
Yeah, he did. Couldn't connect, but as you alluded to, he does have that touchdown from earlier, trying to keep him in the rhythm. So back-to-back incompletions, and that has him staring at a 3rd and 10. From the shotgun, it's Mayfield being chased out left. And a big loss here as he's taken down.
Well, many times when you talk about mobile quarterbacks, you get the sense that they feel like they can get out of any bad situation. They keep moving around and trying to emulate guys like the scrambler or the dodger. Instead, they keep losing yardage and losing yardage and digging themselves a hole that they can't get out of.
And this one hits at the 1, continues on into the end zone for a touchback. The Steelers' offense now, they head back onto the field. They've had it twice. They've punted twice. Not the start they were hoping for.
Not at all, and let's face it, every facility we visit, everyone talks about converting on third down, how big that is. In this situation, they've had to punt it away twice, so they're furiously going over things on the sidelines. What do we need to do to pick up a first down and change our momentum?
Yeah, they'll get it all the way up about 5 yards shy of midfield. A really nice gain of 25 yards. The big play to start him out has him at the 45 already. They'll throw on first down with Roethlisberger. He's just going to dump this one off to his fullback out of the backfield. And he'll go down, but not before getting this inside the 30. A really good pickup of 28 yards. So a 1st and 10 upcoming from Browns territory now at the 27.
Set.
Now it's Roethlisberger. He couldn't quite hold it. Got hit. Ball pops out. Incomplete.
You get a tight end like this, and you know he's used to dishing out punishment, but here, he's one that has to absorb the contact, and as a result, unable to hold on to the football.
2nd and 10 now from the 27.
Set, like 30.
Connor. And only a yard this time as he's taken down right around the 26.
One thing to keep in mind, partner, especially in the second half, when you've got a running back of this size, of these dimensions, I can just tell you, attrition does set in for a defense because you're excited about hitting him in the first half. Maybe not so much in the second half, and some of these shorter gains turn into bigger runs later.
Back with Charles Davis, Brandon Gaudin. It's Steeler football to begin quarter number two. They're on the march, but facing a third down here. To a fourth down.
And the big fella stuffed that one up in a big way. I think doubling him has to be a priority because you can't move up to the next level if you don't take care of him first.
And Boswell has this one going left, no good. He missed it left, and this score will stay right where it is.
It's been a nightmare season. You're well under 500. Your defense hasn't really kept in a lot of games. And now it's spilling over to the kicking game. That's 3 points you've got to be able to bank on.
Mayfield going to lead the Browns up now. First and 10 at about the 32.
Detroit!
Mayfield on first down. Looking left side, that's caught by Landry. A good pickup there, a 22. On first down, they'll run with Chubb. And he's corralled, but not before getting it inside the 35. That'll move the sticks for the Browns, a gain of 12.
And that's the big fella's M.O. right there. Running through tackles, keeping the sticks moving forward. This defense, if you don't bring 11 guys to the ball to try and get him on the ground, he's going to keep making runs like that. I feel the press box shaking every time he touches the rock.
A first down throw for Mayfield. That is incomplete.
I know tight ends love this route because a lot of times they'll fake a block first and get a little bit of space and then come across the middle because in their mind, they're thinking catch the ball and then drop the hammer on the little guys in the secondary.
Unable to drop the hammer, he just dropped the pass. From the 34, they'll come to the line on second and 10. A second down throw for Mayfield. He's going to float this one deep right. And this is caught. Touchdown, Cleveland. In for the score. And the Browns add on to their lead.
Boy, that route is really tough to cover because if they're running it correctly, you think it's really going to be a slant.
Yeah, well, we talk all the time about how it's tough to execute offensively, but you're saying, don't forget, it's tough to cover for the defense, too.
Yeah, the number one thing that you're taught is to not get caught inside or get beat inside. So you guard that a little bit more. So that gives you a little bit more space to operate outside if you start your move initially inside if you're a receiver.
And an alley to run. The Red Sea parts, and there he goes. Past the 20. And into the end zone. Touchdown, Pittsburgh. As his guys are in for six, and the Steelers have now made this a one-score game. They were already down two scores early. They needed something to try to stem that tide, and that certainly qualifies a big play to get them in the end zone.
It qualifies indeed because, let's face it, they don't get something done on this drive, turn it back over. This game could be 88 and out the gate early.
What? 88 and out the gate?
Yeah.
What's that?
Well, listen, I used to hear my old man talk about it. It usually meant that thing's done.
Well, now that they got the touchdown, it's not 88 and out the gate. We still got a good game going ahead of us.
Mayfield going to lead the Browns up now, first and 10 at their own 25-yard line. Intercepted. Picked off right around the 43. And he will return this one to the 30-yard line.
Oh, timing is everything on a route like this. He tried to drive that football into a tight spot. And if you're a little early or a little late, chances are there's going to be someone there. And sure enough, this one's going the other way.
So first and 10 now from the 30. After the interception, here's Roethlisberger. Man open left side is Brown. And taking it to the 15-yard line before he's brought down. A first opportunity for the Steelers in the red zone. First and 10 at the 15. They run with Connor. They stopped after only a yard, taking it down to the 14.
Well, he hasn't made much of an impact in the running game thus far, and after that last run, not much is going to change in that area.
He hasn't been able to get anything going, and really the offensive line not helping him much.
Now Roethlisberger to throw on second down. And he'll take this into the end zone. Now, hold on here. We do have a flag down. So let's see what this is about. They'll come up now on a second and long after the hold. Here's Roethlisberger. Pressure applied, and he's going to be taken down. They sack him back at the 33-yard line. Myles Garrett in there to get him, and that's sack number 6 for him on the year. So the sack, and now a third and long situation for the Steelers and Ben Roethlisberger. From the gun, it's Roethlisberger. He rifles one that's intercepted. Picked up by Denzel Ward. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back.
He had a little bit of the turnover bug last week, 3 interceptions. Not an absolute disaster, but another one here. Do you start to get a little worried?
You worry about your team as a whole because you have to find a way to make those interceptions, quote-unquote, go away. And that means your defense. They've got to go out there on sudden change and at least hold people to field goals. And if that keeps happening, they lose confidence in the quarterback, and then no one plays well.
And he's up past the 10 to about the 12. He'll get a nice chunk there on the first down run, and it's 2nd and 4.
And there we saw one of the downsides of blitzing during a rundown, because sometimes you get out of your gaps. You don't fit the run quite as well because you're headed towards the ball carrier with abandon.
Mayfield now on 2nd down. The quick hitter complete. It's King. That'll put him right at 99 yards receiving now as he's got a first down. Talk about a big first half. Already has the 2 touchdowns, adding to his receiving total there and picking up the first down.
He's coming off the line so fast. I think he's intimidating the defensive backs with his explosiveness, and he's chipping away at their confidence.
This quarterback now, 5 out of 10, 50% throwing it. Not so hot, but he does have a first down.
Gun!
From the gun, Mayfield. steps away to his left. And he can't find a receiver, and he's brought down. Stephon Tuitt, the former Notre Dame man. He's the one that got to him. He takes him down for a loss of 9. Sacks, a growing theme in this first half. This is second and long. Mayfield to throw it. A hit as he throws there, incomplete. The pressure really ratcheting up. They get the sack on first down, then a near sack. They got to him there just as it was leaving his hand.
Yeah, they might need to change their pass protection scheme a little bit. Maybe bring another guy into the backfield to help protect the quarterback, because that was awfully close.
An incomplete pass on that last play, and that means they'll need to come up with something here on third down.
Hurry up, here we go.
Mayfield. And this is going to be incomplete.
Not only was the call spot on, how about the execution of that defense right there? Zone was absolutely locked up tight. He was trying to force it in there on third down.
But if there's a time to force it, he felt like he needed to make a play, right?
Yeah, exactly right. Third down, you got to try and find something. There's nothing available there for him.
A minute 58 to go in this first half of play. More from Cleveland after this. Good starting field position for them here as they come up first and 10. Trying to shake off the interception from the last drive. He'll look to throw. Throw left side complete. That's Brown. And he's got this down to the 35. They may want to go back to that one. First play of the drive, good for 15 and a first down. Throwing now, Roethlisberger on first down. Oh, nearly a disaster there on the check down. But they'll get it back.
Well, nearly another interception there. That would have been two drives in a row with a pick. Here we go. He's got to start taking care of the ball way better than what we're seeing.
Interestingly, that throw was probably worse than the one he threw the interception on last drive, but fell incomplete. Again on second and 10, it's Roethlisberger. And they get to him with a pressure as Roethlisberger goes down. Emmanuel Ogba in there to drop him for his 11th sack of the year. So the sack, and now a third and long situation for the Steelers and Ben Roethlisberger. From the shotgun, it's Roethlisberger. And that is incomplete. E.J. Gaines the one that time to knock it away.
When I watched that play, I thought about what my coaches had told me in the past, the biggest teaching point. Get your head around. Locate the football so you can make a play on it while it's in the air. That's exactly what he did there. That was nice.
And that one's not going to get there. Not enough juice, an ambitious effort. But it's well short, and this score will stay right where it is.
And this is one of the risks you run when you attempt a long field goal. If you miss, the defense takes over the spot of the placement. So now they've got a chance to get one more drive in before halftime.
Mayfield now looking to throw on first down. And he's got the hook up to Landry. And he'll go down shy of the 40 at the 41. A good pickup there. 8 yards on the first down completion. Now a second down throw for Mayfield. And this one grabbed by Darren Fells. Now the Browns signal for the second of their timeouts as they get the stoppage with a little over 50 seconds to go in the first half. Down Mayfield looking left side, and he's got a man. That's Lane. And he will lose yardage here back at the 23-yard line. That'll set him back with a loss of three on the play. And that'll make this a second and 13. Throwing, Mayfield. It's incomplete. Took a shot, couldn't connect. He was trying to get it to his tight end, David Njoku. And it's third down.
Boy, you will not see a quarterback on one like that very often. I mean, there it is, wide open, got the shot, and he misfires.
We talk about, boy, he'll want that one back all the time.
Detroit,
he definitely
Detroit.
Wants that one back.
Third and long for Mayfield. This is caught. And he'll take it into the end zone for a Browns touchdown. In for the score. And the Browns add six to their lead. And that'll give them a two-score lead here, but I'm looking ahead. They just want to hold it for the final moments here of the second quarter. They don't want to give up anything on the other side.
No, not at all, because if they don't, it almost had the feel of an imposing their will score. And right now, they want to make sure they keep that and carry it into the second half.
Here comes Ryan Switzer to return it. And he's up across the 25 and down at the 28-yard line. And the Steelers set to take the field. And with time quickly fading here in the second quarter, not sure how aggressively, offensively they want to play this.
I think we'll find out just how much they trust their guys in this situation if they decide to take a shot.
Final 17 seconds of the half here as they come up to the line, first and 10. The drive will start with Connor. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. Give him 13 yards on the opening play of the drive and also give him a first down. Now a timeout taken. Perhaps a chance for one more quick play and then another timeout if they hurry. We'll see. Now Roethlisberger on first down. Into heavy traffic and it's intercepted. Picked off by the Michigan man, Jabril Peppers. At a potential turning point as they'll get the football in very good field position late in this first half. Final play of the half, Mayfield. He's going to let this one go deep. And incomplete on the deep ball.
So he comes out of nowhere. He's got this handlebar mustache, greasy hair. And he says, would you rather eat a jar of mayonnaise or three sticks of butter? And I'm like, what? All right, never mind.
Third quarter action now. The Steeler offense now with a football first here to begin the third quarter. They have the ball here for the inaugural drive of the second half. Pretty big deficit, though. We'll see what adjustments were made in that locker room.
And I never want to make something more important than it actually is, right? I don't want to create more hype than what is there.
But this
is a
real,
I'm doing it, though. This is a really important drive. And we often talk about teams scripting plays to start a game. A lot of them script to start the second half, too. And they're scripting something that they expect to get them into the end zone and back into this game.
We'll see if that script is a good one for them. They'll break the huddle, come up on second and eight at the 27-yard line. They stay on the ground. Here's Connor again. And this has been a familiar sight all afternoon as they stop him behind the line. Call it a loss of two on the play. And that's going to make it third down and 10. This offense in desperate need of a conversion as they come up on third down. On third down, Roethlisberger. He's going deep for Brown. That's going to be knocked away and incomplete. Jabril Peppers, a former first-round pick, there on the coverage.
We're into the second half now, and this is an offense that continues to struggle to sustain a drive.
Looks like they're just totally out of sync, whether they're running the ball, passing the ball like we saw there. I don't know. The rhythm seems off. Spins past another.
My man.
Give him 11 yards that time on the return, and the Browns will take over first and 10. Here's the Browns now. They get set for their first possession of the third quarter. This is sort of what you would call a put-away drive, isn't it? They score here, especially a touchdown. It's almost out of reach.
It certainly feels that way, and I think that they're going to call their plays accordingly, because what you really want to do, even though you know the scoreboard is still up there and the game's going to go on, in fact, you can take the spirit away from another team, that their drive and will to come back and win can be taken if there's another score right here.
Still third quarter, but you just get that feel.
Yeah, they're teetering right there on the brink, aren't they?
Into heavy traffic, and it's intercepted. Read it well, and it's picked. And his guys will set up shop at midfield at the 50-yard line.
I tell you, Brandon, it seems like this guy's been all over the field so far. That's his second interception of the game, and so much of playing defense in the NFL, especially when it comes to defending the pass, is all about positioning and technique. And this is fantastic work on both fronts there.
And the Browns pressure gets to him that time, and he's going to go down. Joe Schobert coming on the blitz. He gets him for a loss of 7. Don't need it all back at once, but you figure they're going to need something here. 17 yards to go on second down. Out of the gun, it's Roethlisberger. And this one's incomplete. Antonio Brown, the intended receiver. And that takes us from second to third down. And Charles, got to like what this defense has been able to do these last couple of plays.
Yeah, they get the sack on first down, then they force the incomplete pass. Now they're just a play away from getting the football right back. But it's a big play. They've got to hold up.
An incomplete pass on that last play, and that means they'll need to come up with something here on third down. Roethlisberger. And Big Ben intercepted a third time. Picked off by the linebacker, Joe Schobert. And they'll start out with great field position at the 47-yard line in enemy territory. Carry for their fullback. So a nice job to break the one tackle, but not much daylight after that as he's brought down. TJ Watt in on the tackle.
And there's the pickup you want on first down. All offenses say, you get me 4 on first down, we'll take it. How about if you get 5? They'll really be happy.
They go with Chubb on second down, and he'll take this one down to about the 40. Still a couple yards short of the first as the 3-yard gain brings up a third down.
Third quarter and you've got the lead. You're not ready to go into that 4-minute offense to close the game out, but a running game can really benefit your team right now.
The Browns on third down. They've hit 2 for 4 thus far. This time they face a 3rd and 2.
Gun, gun! Gun, gun! Leopard! Leopard! Detroit! Detroit! Watch it now, Barney! Barney!
To throw, Mayfield. Nowhere to escape, and he goes down.
The amount of sacks that they've absorbed in this game is absolutely extraordinary. Let's just face it. This offensive line, flat out, cannot handle this pass rush. It's been demonstrated time and time again.
And this is off target to the left. Didn't get there anyway. It's no good. And this score will stay right where it is.
Well, this winds up an empty possession. Everything looked okay. He just never got the ball on target. And knowing him, he'll be disappointed with that effort.
Now they're set up nicely at the 45-yard line after the missed field goal from 55. They go back to the air here after the INT on the last drive. Wide open receiver complete. And he'll be brought down somewhat awkwardly here, and a late flag as well. I think this one's going to be a face mask. So the yellow flag came out, and that leads to a new set of downs for this offense, first and 10. Here's Roethlisberger. And his pass is intercepted for the fourth time today. Picked off inside the 10. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back. Charles, whatever's going on between his ears right now, it's just not completely calculated correctly. 7 picks between last week and this week after that one.
And they always say the most important part of a player is those 6 inches between the ears. But right now, it's all those interceptions that are going on. So whoever his trusted confidant is on the sidelines, I don't know if it's the offense coordinator, quarterback's coach, maybe the backup quarterback, that's who he needs to get with.
He's got a man complete. He's at the 40. The 20, 10, and all the way in. Touchdown, Cleveland. A big play there. 92 yards. And the Browns add on to their lead. Still plenty of time left in the game, but now starting to pull away a little bit. Get some breathing room with that one.
And I don't want people to think that NFL locker rooms are cookie cutter, that everyone's saying the exact same thing in every situation. But I do know that all 32 teams have an emphasis on starting fast. Game, you know, the second half, no matter what, with his first 5 minutes, first three, whatever, this was a big score to start the second half.
And Pittsburgh getting set to take the field. And they had a nice little drive going last time through the interception in the red zone. Costly.
Bad enough to throw it anywhere, but that drives coaches insane when they're thinking about, hey, we got a shot at points already. We're already in a spot where you're thinking you've got 3 on the board for sure, and to come away with nothing.
And now nothing but green ahead of him. And out across midfield, down to the 45. All told, it's an even 30 and a first down.
At this stage of the game, the run-pass numbers are a little bit out of whack because most of the yardage has come through the air. But in a sense, that just sets things up for big runs like that because the defense might be a little bit off balance. They pick up another first down with that run.
Set. Blue 30. 30.
Running game working. They'll stick with it on first down. And he's going to get this one down near the 45-yard line. Just a yard on the first down carry, so it's 2nd and 9.
They went right back to him, but he pretty much had nowhere to go on that play.
Yeah, the previous carry looked pretty good. That one, maybe he was a little tired. I don't know.
Yeah, maybe he should have tapped out and had a second back come in and maybe make that run. Who knows?
Now a toss. This is Connor. Got some real estate inside the 30. And he's got it all the way down to the 12-yard line. That one good for 33 and a first.
This has been a good drive so far, and it's been a running game for the most part that's powered them down there. Another nice burst there, picking up a first down. Now it's 1st and 10, as you said, in the red zone.
So how about this for field position after the big play? Inside the 15 now as they come up on 1st and 10. Now they'll run it on the toss. And it looks like he'll be just a yard shy of the 5 here as he's out at the 6. It's a 6-yard pickup, but it gets him to 2nd and 4.
Looks like they're establishing a pretty good pattern here because they've been very heavy in the running game on the last 4 plays.
Yeah, you took the words right out of my mouth. So far, 4 plays in this drive, all 4 on the ground. And on the ground they go with a running back. And he'll be brought down right on the edge of the goal line at about the 1-yard line. A 5-yard gain, and now they're set up 1st and goal.
Well, as the play call comes in on 3rd down, you have to think about 4-down territory here. Down a few touchdowns, they need points, and they need big points.
They've been in the red zone 3 times in this game and have not scored a single point. Can they break through here on 2nd and goal? Toss play, Connor, and he's in. Touchdown, Pittsburgh. A great effort there. His 3rd touchdown now on the year. And the Steelers are able to cut into that deficit. Boswell good with the extra point. And that cuts the lead to 28-14. The kickoff team on the field now as they will send this one away. To return it now, here's King. And nice work on the return as he'll start their drive just past the 30-yard line. And now Cleveland geared up to take the field. And last time, the formula was pretty simple. One play drive, long pass. That maybe they just want to do that again, right?
And that's exactly how you want to draw things up. Whether it's on your grease board, right, in your playbook, one play drive is exactly what you want on offense. What they have to be careful of is not having a letdown. It was fairly easy last time. They can't expect that going forward.
And we'll see if it's that easy here.
Stepping up, he's going to keep it. Right off the bat, it's a first down to start the drive, 12 yards.
I think the last two plays really illustrate how difficult it is to game plan against this guy because, you know, he can throw the football, but how about his use of legs as well? What we call those broken plays, you can't account for them.
Yeah, those plays, those two that you just mentioned, a microcosm, really a part of it. And he is into the end zone. Touchdown, Cleveland. David Njoku, his third touchdown now on the year. And the Browns add 6 to their lead. When they drew that up, I don't think they envisioned it ending in a house call, but he got it and took it all the way home.
Really impressive run after the catch, wasn't it? That was really special by him. But let's face it, in today's NFL, those tight ends are often former wide receivers or maybe even sometimes bigger running backs. They just put them in a position to get a great matchup and make plays like that.
The Steelers' offense now, they get ready to head back on the field. I guess they have to feel a little gratified to at least get on the board last time, but still work to do.
No doubt about it. I wonder now if they're going to try to increase the urgency a little bit, maybe pump up the pace, maybe go 2 minutes. Who knows? Let's see what they decide to do.
It's Connor as they stay on the ground. And he will lose yardage and be backed up to the 24. That's going to go as a loss of a yard, and it'll be second down.
Well, that's pretty symptomatic about how things have gone here. That play was just shut down right from the start.
And not going to give them a lot of confidence to help turn things around.
After the loss to start out, here's second and 11.
All right, let's go get it now, all right?
Back. Again, it's Connor. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. The Steelers able to pick up 18 yards there.
We'll definitely see some open running lanes, and he's taking advantage of it right now, but that shouldn't be a surprise. Defense has the lead. They're playing for the pass first.
Now they'll run it on the toss. And not much there at all. Maybe a yard up to the 43.
Well, they had that one sniffed out. Excellent run blitz. Stopped that one for a short gain.
What makes a good run blitz a good run blitz?
The ability to stay on task, to follow up your assignment, go to the gap you're supposed to cover, and not be deterred by anything else.
Now it's Connor. And he'll take this one across the 45 up to about the 46-yard line. Give him 3 yards, and now they're left needing a conversion here on 3rd and 6. Now they'll run it on the toss, and he'll lose yardage on the play back at the 45-yard line. That'll make it 4th down after a loss of 1. A critical one here if they're going to have any shot at this thing. So they'll go for it on 4th down. Got to try it here. He's back to throw. He's going to fire this thing deep right side. It's caught inside the 25. And he takes this just a few yards shy of the red zone before going out. No reason not to try it there, and they do indeed convert on 4th. So the big play gets him all the way down to the outskirts of the red zone here for first and 10. Boy, and now they can't even get a playoff. So that'll back him up five. So a little bit of a stiffer challenge now. First and 15 following the delay of game. Now they'll run it on the toss. And maybe a measure of revenge there. He's had his way in this one, but this time they get him behind the line. This will be a 2-yard loss on the play. And it'll make this a second and long. And now here's another interception. Picked up by the Michigan man, Jabril Peppers. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back. Yet another interception, and I just had to double-check my math. But it is now 8 between last week and this week.
Well, I just used a calculator. I didn't worry about double-checking it. But the thing that always throws me when you see quarterbacks in this type of a bad spot, they're trying to figure out what they can do to change it, and sometimes they try too hard, and they never get out of it. And that's where he is right now. He's just locked in a really bad way.
And he's brought down, but not before they get it across the 20-yard line. An excellent way to start the drive there, 18 yards. Now they can breathe a little easier, some room to operate as they've got it first and 10 now out past the 20. They run again on first down, Chubb. And he'll take it ahead to the 28-yard line. It's a 6-yard gain on the ground, and that'll make it second and 4.
Bottom line, they want to keep this clock rolling, so they'll take that one right there. They just want to keep falling forward, and they want to put the onus on the big fellas up front in order to bring this one home.
They pitch it to Chubb. And hit behind the line. He lost the football. It's loose. Looking to find a lane, but he can't. Reined in at the line of scrimmage. The Browns on third down, 2 for 5 to this point. This is third and 4.
Lucky 56, lucky 56. Detroit.
Mayfield down. Over the middle, complete. It's King. And now the ball's out, fumble near midfield. And it looks like Steeler football. It is. Well, he did what he's known for. He made the catch, then he turned into a runner, took the contact, and coughed it up.
And all I remember as a player, when they catch the ball, when those acrobatic guys catch it, you have to make them pay sometimes. You have to put it on them, big tackle, knock the ball free. Anything you can do to slow them down.
Rush coming, and he's taken down. Myles Garrett, he's the one to get him, and that's sack number 7 for him on the year. Got to assume this defense will be charging again here. It's second and 15. Time for a break. This one, all over but the shouting. We'll finish it after this. Coming up now on a second and 15 following that sack. Here's Roethlisberger to throw. And the pressure gets to him again. Miles. Miles Garrett in there to get him, and that's sack number 8 for him on the year.
We've been around this league for a while, and many coaches never pull their starting quarterback, almost no matter the situation. In this case, though, I think he's got to make a decision. He's taking a pretty good beating out there.
Yeah, and with the deficit, maybe not wanting to risk an injury.
Now Ben on third and long. He's going to let it fly. And he couldn't hang on to it through the contact. Incomplete.
This defense was definitely alert to the possibility of the deep ball, and they were more than ready for it.
They've got the lead fourth quarter. Maybe can expect more passes like that downfield.
Caution. Skelet AP is frosted. I sit back and read the offense. Was it did it the falses? Chanel, bag is off Chanel. Straight down, come up in the process.
Hey.
Private jet, yeah.
Yeah.
The same diamond milk, yeah. I'ma keep the on welfare. Yeah. The pink stone real, real.
Real.
Bling, bling, blow, yeah.
Bling, bling.
Mama got style, yeah.
Style.
Chanel reptile player.
Hey.
On Mars, gotta get the grace of the God.
Grace to God.
Three rock stars, nobody seeing the gang on guard.
God.
Chaos is in my mental. You need a PJ first class, not what you went to. You need to relay, chase money like Usain. I'll give you the boat, chain, and plane.
Fame, name, that's insane.
Pop the.
Nah.
You need a, in case the movies get insane.
Nah.
You need a ruby, the kind of jewelry that's from the rain.
No.
I'm just here to remind you, but never mommy, man. I'm here to remind you where you come from. All this peace retreat is lame, done. You can never get rid of me, I live in you.
Live in you.
Both of our five fin you.
Different city with some different. Here we go. I spend the whole emotional code.
been somebody keep checking my paws. Walking in the club with no warning, take care of the money. They swing on the water on me like the sunny. I shine when it's sunny, this platinum and rose. Gonna out the street when I go to DC, I'ma see the mall.
Every time I'm gone, I get another. Tryna leave me long, another. I'm like, baby, I know I'm wrong, but this just how life goes.
Riding the rose, I put some ice on my wrist, it was walls. Then I got tired of with you.